Belinda presents this unabridged recording of Kitten Kingdom, Volume 2, Tabby and the Catfish, and Tabby Takes the Crown. Written by Mia Bell and read by Roslyn Oades. With special thanks to Conrad Mason, for Emma McGeechee. Chapter 1, The Golden Boat.
"Raise the anchor!" cried Princess Tabby.
"Set sail!"
said her younger brother Leo.
"Oh, stop rushing me!"
grumbled Felix, their older brother. The royal kittens were crouching on a grassy bank in the palace gardens. The river ran past, crystal clear and sparkling in the sunshine.
"It's the perfect day to try out our toy boat," thought Tabby. "If only Felix would stop messing with it."
The black cat was carefully checking every sail to make sure they were on straight.
"Let me do it,"
said Leo, reaching for the boat. But Felix pulled it away and set it gently in the water.
"Wow!"
they all gasped together. The boat sailed along, ticking like a watch. Their friend Claudia's father had made it out of shining gold. It had a little clockwork engine, moving sails, and an anchor that went up and down.
"It's the best toy ever,"
said Tabby as the boat sailed under a stone bridge.
"I'll get it on the other side,"
called Leo. He ran off in a flash of orange fur.
"But it's my turn next,"
yelled Tabby. She chased after him.
"Careful,"
shouted Felix, following.
"Don't break it."
The three kittens ran along the riverbank, their tails waving behind them. Tabby was the first one past the bridge and the first to see the boat come bobbing out.
"There it is!"
Tabby leaned over the water, reaching as far as she could.
"Whoops!"
cried Felix. Tabby turned and saw him slip on the wet grass. He grabbed Leo's paw, but Leo wobbled and bumped into Tabby. Thump! Tabby lost her balance. She waved her paws and stuck out her tail, but it was no good.
Splash!
All three royal kittens plunged into the river. The cold water soaked Tabby. She splashed and shivered.
"It's horrible!"
she cried. She hated getting wet, just as much as any other kittizen in Mewtopia.
"My whiskers are stuck to my face!"
wailed Felix, popping up next to Tabby.
"I've got water in my ears!"
yelled Leo.
"I can't hear a thing!"
Tabby tried to stay calm.
"A kitty hero shouldn't be afraid of a little water.
Let's kitty paddle back to the bank," she said, "like Nanny Mittens taught us."
Together, the royal kittens kicked hard with their back paws and paddled with their front paws. They splashed their way back to the grass and pulled themselves up. They sat panting on the bank. Their fur was all flat and water dripped from their whiskers.
"Leaping fleas," said Felix. "I'm glad that's over."
"Did anyone get the boat?"
asked Leo, rubbing his ears. Tabby spotted it drifting away from them.
"There it is,"
she pointed. But it was already out of reach and moving fast in the current.
"We'll never get it back now,"
said Leo sadly.
"It was my favourite toy."
"It's not yours," said Felix. "And it wouldn't even have floated if I hadn't fixed the sails."
"But if you hadn't been so clumsy, we never would have lost it,"
said Tabby.
"That's enough," said a familiar meow.
The royal kittens turned. King Pouncelot and Queen Elizabeth were walking over the grass toward them, dressed in their crowns and red capes. Normally, Tabby was glad to see her parents, but today they looked very annoyed.
King Pouncelot gave each kitten a stern look.
Haven't we warned you about playing near water? We're cats for meow sick.
And all of this arguing, added Queen Elizabeth, today of all days.
The peace parade will begin soon, said King Pouncelot, and here you are fighting. Well, I'm afraid we can't let you ride on the royal boat with us now.
The royal kittens gasped.
But we always go on the royal boat, cried Tabby. We love the peace parade, added Felix. All the different boats and the kittens cheering and the brass band playing.
You'll have to watch all that from beside the river, said Queen Elizabeth.
But,
began Leo.
Not another word, said Queen Elizabeth. Back to your rooms and get dry.
Tabby and her brothers were still shivering and dripping as they went through a side door into the palace courtyard. Tabby felt ashamed.
I can't believe we ruined our chance to be part of the peace parade. What's going on over there?
Said Felix. Tabby saw a little crowd of cat lords and ladies by a door, talking excitedly. They all wore their best clothes, ready for the peace parade.
Make way!
Called a voice from inside. Then Captain Edmund came marching out. The big orange tomcat was wearing his shiniest silver armour, and in one paw he held a golden torch. Magical orange flames flickered from the end.
Meowza!
Gasped Leo.
It's the torch of peace!
Tabby couldn't help it. Her tail flicked with excitement.
Last one there's a stinky rat, she called. Mum and Dad said...
began Felix. But Tabby was already running across the courtyard, leaving wet paw prints behind her. She pushed through the crowd with Leo, then Felix following.
Slow down there, kitties,
cried Captain Edmund. He held the torch away from them.
This torch has been lit for 100 years, and we can't have you splashing water on it.
Is it the torch of peace, sir?
Asked Leo. He stopped next to Tabby.
Is it true that it's really magical? Is it true that it keeps the peace among all kittizens all through the land?
It most certainly is, replied Captain Edmund, and it will travel with the king and queen on the royal boat.
Tabby's whiskers drooped.
I wish we could be on the boat, she said sadly. Mum and Dad said we have to watch from the riverbank.
Captain Edmund ruffled her ears.
Cheer up, young Tabby. At least that rotten rat king, Gorgonzola, won't cause any trouble this time. I hear the Whiskered Wonders dunked him in a big bowl of cheese. The rascal's probably too ashamed to show his whiskers in Mewtopia ever again.
At the mention of the Whiskered Wonders, Tabby and Leo shared a knowing look. If only Captain Edmund knew the truth.
We have to go now, said Felix. Nanny Mittens will be waiting for us.
See you at the parade,
called Captain Edmund, and he marched off again with the torch held high. Leo giggled as the royal kittens darted away up the stairs to their bedchamber in the tallest tower in the palace.
Imagine what Captain Edmund would say if he knew that we are the Whiskered Wonders, he said. Secret heroes of Mewtopia.
Leo and Felix gave each other a high paw. But Tabby was thinking of the Wicked Rat King with his iron crown, greasy fur, and cruel yellow eyes. He would do anything to take over their kingdom.
I have a feeling that he won't let a bit of cheese get in his way.
Oh, bless my whiskers!
gasped Nanny Mittens when the royal kittens finally reached their room.
You look like drowned mice. Well, never mind. You must all look your best for the peace parade. Get your towels and quickly, please.
While Tabby and her brothers dried off, the big white cat picked out their nicest clothes and laid them on their baskets. Tabby saw that Nanny Mittens had brushed her whiskers and combed her fur, but she was still wearing her frilly apron.
You haven't got dressed up yet either, Nanny,
said Leo.
Oh, my word, you're right.
Nanny Mittens swept out of the room, calling behind her.
Into your clothes, my dears. The parade is about to begin.
As soon as Nanny Mittens had closed the door, Tabby flung open their dress-up box.
We should put our Whiskered Wonders costumes on underneath, she said.
Felix nibbled his claws nervously.
Why? You don't think we'll need them at the peace parade, do you?
I hope not, said Tabby. But I don't think we've seen the last of Gorgonzola. And if he tries to cause any trouble, we'll be ready for him.
Chapter 2 Peace Parade.
Thank goodness for Nanny Mittens, said King Pouncelot, as Tabby and her brothers climbed into the royal carriage in the courtyard. You kitties look perfect.
Almost perfect,
said Queen Elizabeth. She licked her paw and scrubbed Leo's ears with it. Tabby grinned as the carriage moved off.
Soon we'll be at the river.
She patted her skirt carefully. She had hidden 3 swords under it, just in case.
But I hope we don't have to use them.
The carriage rolled out of the palace and down the royal avenue. Kittizens crowded the street, cheering and clapping as they passed. Tabby's heart raced with excitement. Then they turned a corner and the kittens gasped.
The royal boat!
It was long and wooden, floating on the river, painted white and gold. A big red flag flew from the mast, showing the golden claws of Mewtopia. The banks of the river were completely full of kittizens. They sat on picnic rugs, dressed in their best clothes, munching tuna sandwiches and sipping iced milk.
They're all waiting for us,
said Leo, his tail flicking with excitement.
And you must behave yourselves for them, said King Pouncelot, wagging a claw. Royal kittens must set a good example for little kitties all over the kingdom.
At last the carriage door swung open.
Greetings, kittizens,
called Queen Elizabeth. The royal family climbed down from the carriage. The kittizens leaped to their paws, clapping wildly and throwing colourful confetti. Another carriage rolled up behind theirs. Nanny Mittens climbed out. She wore a green dress and a large pink hat shaped like a rose. Captain Edmund followed, proudly carrying the torch of peace. It was glowing brighter than ever. All around, kittizens fell silent in amazement.
It's the torch! One whispered. Isn't it beautiful? Sighed another.
I hope he doesn't drop it,
whispered Felix, nibbling his claws again. Captain Edmund marched to the river, his armour shining in the light of the flames. Then he kneeled down. Tabby and her brothers followed their parents to the edge of the water. King Pouncelot took the torch from Captain Edmund. He held it up high so that every cat could see it.
Behold the torch of peace, said Queen Elizabeth. May our celebration today bring all cats and kittens together, and may there be peace in Mewtopia forever.
Everyone cheered, and the king and queen bowed. Then they walked.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.